The following video is brought to you by Pasco County Schools on behalf of Superintendent Kurt Browning. Thousands of people move to Florida every year, especially Pasco County. After all, it is a great place to work, or retire, or raise a family. But let's face it, no place is perfect. And there may come a time when you will be asked to evacuate your home. And for many people, that will mean going to a shelter, and often the shelter will be a school. That's why it's important for Florida residents, and especially coastal residents, to review evacuation information and create a plan of action should evacuation be necessary. Part of that plan should include stocking up on emergency supplies to support you and your family for at least 72 hours. Some of the basic items on your list should be non-perishable food items, water, potable for cooking and drinking, non-potable for flushing toilets, protective clothing such as rain gear, put medications and important documents in a waterproof container, flashlights and fresh batteries, paper money in case ATMs or credit card readers aren't working. If you use a generator, make sure you have gas for it, and place it as far away from your house as possible to avoid the exhaust fumes. Make sure your gas tank is full in your vehicle. A battery-powered radio is extremely helpful for monitoring new developments or warnings. If you are unable to evacuate, remain inside the most secure part of your home or building and stay away from windows. If you have nowhere to go and you are advised to evacuate, you may need to go to a shelter. This is not the same thing as going to a hotel. Usually, there are only basic facilities available, like a floor and a roof. Most shelters do not provide any sort of bedding or cribs, so it would be a good idea to bring a mat or something soft to sleep on. There may be meals provided, but you shouldn't count on it. It would be smart to bring your own water and snacks. And refrigeration may also not be available. Some of the rules for staying at a shelter include no drugs or alcohol, except medications, of course, no firearms or any sort of weapon, no tobacco products or matches or lighters are allowed inside the shelter. Parents are responsible for keeping track of their children. If you came in your car, you should keep it locked and remove any valuables. Keep those with you. Sleeping areas are quiet areas at all times, and lights go out between 10 p.m. and 6 a.m. If you leave the shelter or return, you must check in at the registration area. Now, just a few more things to keep in mind. Some shelters don't allow pets, so it's a good idea to check ahead of time to see if you can bring yours. You will need to bring your own crate and supplies and be able to show that your pet is up to date on all their shots and vaccinations. Here's a list of items you'll need to bring with your pet. A proper ID collar with rabies tag and preferably with name and address on it. Vaccination paperwork. Carrier or cage or crate. A leash, of course. Plenty of food and water. 2 weeks worth is good. Bowls for water or food, medications, newspapers or cat litter with a scoop, plastic bags for handling waste. Bring a photo of you and your pet together for identification, a favorite toy or blanket, a can opener, non-electric of course. It's great if your pet has a microchip. And finally, just in case your pet has an accident, you might want to have cleaning supplies handy. As a community, we can get through times of crisis if we work together. Our staff are committed to keeping you safe until you can return home. Please take the time to put your plan together so you are prepared. For more information on how to prepare for an emergency or disaster, go to pascocountyfl.net/emergency management.